Christian Uck, it's CES 2024. I'm in the West Hall looking at automotive technology today. One of the issues that's come up is the controversy between using stereo cameras versus LIDAR for detection of objects that may be outside of the field of view of the driver. This is an important capability, just not only for safety purposes, being able to see objects in snow, fog, dark, low visibility conditions, but it's also going to be a requirement, I think it's a requirement, for level 3 ADAS certification, so and parts of autonomous driving as well. So the issue here is with LIDAR, you are sending out physical laser pulses and range gating those to create a point cloud of data. You can use 1550 lasers, you can use 980 lasers. These can be single lasers that are scanned over the field of view, or they can be small array of lasers. The small array of lasers are going to give you probably more, perhaps more resolution, less latency, higher frame rates. So there are some advantages, obviously a cost trade-off for that. On the other hand, you have stereo cameras that can be used now with algorithms to generate depth maps and to generate point clouds. And those algorithms can theoretically be used now to identify objects and track those objects as the car is moving down the road. And potentially also to track the velocity of moving objects, not just stationary objects that are out there. The controversy here is that while LIDAR is a physical method for determining this information, it's more expensive. There are a number of RFPs out there for LIDAR, so you will see LIDAR in cars going forward, but the cost is the challenge here. And so that's why you're seeing some companies here at CES trying to offer these camera-based solutions. You do have to move to stereo cameras in the front of the car. Typically, those cars only have a single camera right now, although I believe Mercedes E-Class does have stereo cameras. So lower cost solution, trade-off in terms of accuracy, because these are calculated algorithms and calculated object detection and tracking. So those are the trade-offs. We'll have to see how this is going to evolve going forward. Chris Chenock here for Insight Media.